I believe that I was so friendly in the school in the interview, and I wasn't, acting as a student that he's, is being scared from the questions that he's gonna receive. And this is what I think attracted the attention of the interviewer. So I didn't show him that I'm feeling stressful. Of course, from my inside, I was so stressful. Hi everyone, this is Osama from Palestine. So first of all, I hope everything's going well with you. Currently, I'm doing my master's in Ankara University in the Department of Biomedical Engineering. At the same time, I'm the recipient of the Turkish scholarships in 2021. I have put so many different preferences regarding the major, regarding the language, and regarding everything to show that I'm flexible with anything. But still, being flexible should be controlled, well controlled. So it is not logical to put the first preference as an engineering and the second preference as a dentistry or medicine and the third preference as a business or economy. And I have got my second choice, not my first choice. And I know the reason why, because the first choice, which was Bilkent, they wanted three different exams. They wanted the GRE exam for the masters, and they wanted the TOEFL exam, and they wanted the SAT exam. So for me, I had only the SAT and the TOEFL, and I didn't get the GRE. That's why I wasn't accepted in the first preference. I have got this email on 26th of July, so at the end of July, and they have asked me to come to the interview after 2 weeks. For my case, I was in Turkey, so they asked me to attend the interview, whether in Istanbul or in Ankara, in their offices, and it was face-to-face for my case, since I was in Turkey. If for some people, for example, my friends in Gaza, which is in Palestine, they couldn't come, so for their case, their interviews were online. So I have arrived to the place of the interview, and there were like 10 students or 15 students waiting, and a guy came and he like said, okay, let's make a list for you. After that, we just entered one by one. The interview place was kind of office, and there was a guy inside, and there was only one guy, by the way, and it wasn't so difficult. So for my case, they have called me. I have entered the interview, and I said hello. Like, I think he knows that I was in Turkey, so he replied in Turkish and he said merhaba. And then he said that your Turkish is good and let's continue in Turkish. But I said, like, here's an example. For example, I didn't show him that I'm stressful. I told him, no, can you please continue in English, because I feel more comfortable in English. And he says yes. He said yes, no problem, of course. So regarding the language of your interviewers, very normal to choose the language that you want. Okay, it's not necessary to be in Turkish or English. You can just choose the language that you want. And everything was very friendly, and we just proceeded in this case. First of all, he said, like, what is your name? And he wants you to introduce yourself by yourself. After that, he asks you to sit down, okay? And then he asked me, do you have any documents? And I said, yes, here are my documents. I have brought all the documents that they may ask in my, and all the documents that I have put in my scholarship application, I've got them as a hard copy so they can check it. I've given my documents, and he started opening them one by one. After checking my documents, he said, okay. He opened his application, my application from his system, from his computer, and he started asking usual questions. So the first question was, where did you graduate from? And why did you come to Turkey? And why do you want to study this major? So since my major was kind of related to biology, and at that time we have the pandemic, so he asked me, have you got vaccinated? And I said no. And he said, why? Like, are you against the vaccination? Like, I didn't get, scared from this question, sorry. However, I got kind of confused, because at that time, even the professors in the world and the scientists, they weren't sure from the vaccine whether it's good or not. So I couldn't know, should I say no or not? That's why in my answer, I was kind of diplomatic. So I didn't say yes. I didn't say neither yes nor no. I just mentioned that if the vaccine was really good and useful for the people, and it protects people from any diseases, then I think we need to take it. But first of all, but also we need to make sure that it has no dangerous side effects. And since our scientists, and I said since Turkey and the Turkish government says that it doesn't have any risky side effects, then I think I will take it. This was my answer. First of all, as I told you, like, I mentioned the Turkish government that, and we trust it, and etc. It was a good point, I believe. And this is how it passed. So this was the only difficult question that I have faced. Other questions he asked me, like, he told me, do you want to stay here or do you want to go back to your country? I told him, no, definitely I will go back to my country. I will not stay here. I told him, maybe if I stay, I will stay for 1 year to get experience and also to benefit Turkey, since I have got education from them. And since they have giving me some education and giving me some help, so I need to repay them back, and I need to do something significant in Turkey as a project, for example. After I benefit Turkey and I leave here some, you know, good, how can I say, spot behind me, then I can leave Turkey and go back to my hometown, because in my country they need my major is not present and they need some help. And you know, I just mentioned that I will not stay in their country, I want to go back to my hometown. There was only one question that made me, you know, kind of got scared or stressful, and it was the following. He told me, okay, you have applied to Ankara University and you have the conditions, however Ankara University needs TOEFL exam, but you don't have TOEFL exam, so how will you enter there? This was a really terrifying question for me. I told him that I have applied to the TOEFL exam and I will do it soon, in the coming days I will go and do it, and the result will be announced in 2 weeks. So after the result is announced, definitely I will send them to you. And I showed him at this part that I'm really confident. I told him that I've done the exam, it was a piece of cake for me. I told him it was so easy for me, I couldn't do it before because I was so busy with my graduation project and in the bachelor's, that's why I couldn't do it before, but I have applied to the TOEFL. I showed him that I know what Ankara University want, or the other choices the other universities want. I asked him, can you please give me an email that I can send this document through? And this was only the question that I felt kind of stressful, whether like maybe it will affect my application since I don't have TOEFL, so maybe they will reject me. And like I gave him, you know, convincing reason why I couldn't do the TOEFL before. And after the interview in 1 month, but usually they reply in 2 weeks, as far as he said, because I asked him this question and he told me, no, like you will learn about your interview result or scholarship result within 2 weeks, or maximum 3 weeks. Like after 25 days I was informed that I have got accepted in their scholarship. So before saying that the interview, I think that it was good, it was really good for me, like, because you know, I believe that I was so friendly in the school, in the interview, and I wasn't, you know, acting as a student that he's, you know, is being scared from the questions that he's gonna receive or she's gonna receive. I was so friendly in this interview, and this is what I think attracted the attention of the interviewer. So he saw me very friendly and kind of like I know him from several years, you know, and I didn't show him that I'm feeling stressful. Of course, from my inside, I was so stressful. I was feeling so stressful, by the way. So regarding the interview, I can just briefly say that it was so friendly. And the most important thing in the interview, I believe that you need to show them that you are not stressful, and you need to show them that you are highly confident and you trust yourself. So this really affects your interview result at the end. Like when I entered as if the office that I'm entering is my own office, you know, of course with some respect. And like when I entered there, I was wearing some casual clothes because the dress code was casual clothes, and I was so confident. You should not show them that you feel stressful, and you should answer the questions just very normally. Let's say that he asked you some question and you can say, just can you repeat again, and you can say that sorry, I couldn't understand the question, can you say it again? So it's so, you should be so calm and confident in the interview, and sit properly. Of course, sitting properly is really important. Of course, you cannot drink or smoke cigarette, let's say, or eat. Of course, these things are not allowed in the interview. I believe that you all know it.